Hello,
I am Sanju B. Naik, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I am explaining the design of flat belt drive using manufacturer's data. At the end of the session, the students will be able to design the flat belt drive for given application using manufacturer's data. Belt drives consist of pulleys mounted on driver and driven shaft, and a continuous belt is passed on the pulleys which transmit the power. So belt drives are extensively used for industrial application like conveyors, compressors, machine tools, etc. Belts and pulleys are being mechanical standard elements available in the market. These are required to be selected from manufacturer's data for all practical application. Hence, the objective of design of the belt drive is nothing but to decide upon the diameter of smaller pulley here called as driving pulley and diameter of this driven pulley, which is normally bigger one, and the cross section of the belt, which is a rectangular one having the width and certain thickness, the length of the belt passing over both the pulleys having certain center distance. So this becomes an objective of design. To satisfy this objective, the input data which is required is power to be transmitted P in kilowatt, input speed N1 in RPM, particularly driver speed, the output speed is a driven pulley speed is N2. Sometimes we may use the velocity ratio as a N1 by N2 to decide upon the diameters, and center distance in meters, the belt velocity V in meters per second, normally referred certain standard values from the point of view of economy and life of the belt, which has been suggested by the manufacturer. The belt system may be either open or cross. In case of cross system, the belt is going to pass over this pulley and connect it cross to this pulley and passing once again from this side and connect it to this end. So this is a cross system, whereas this is open system. So based upon the open or cross system, the length of the belt is required to be calculated, and hence one has to consider whether it is open or cross system from the point of view of sometimes space consideration. The service conditions has to be taken into account, because the belt may be operated for continuous hours of duty like 8 hours, 16 hours, 24 hours in different environment, as well as in terms of shock load conditions, minor shock, normal load, shock load, etc. And naturally the manufacturer's data. So with use of all this input data, we can design the belt system. So calculation of pitch diameter of pulleys, which can be done by help of a velocity known at particular speed of the pulley N1, we can make use of V is equal to pi D1 N1 by 60, in which we can calculate the diameter D1. And this diameter calculated may be any value. We have to select some standard pitch diameter as D1 from available catalog, which is the nearest value to calculated one. Once this D1 is decided or fixed, we can go for calculating D2. Calculate D2, we use equation N1 by N2 is equal to D2 by D1. Here it is without considering the slip, but sometimes at high speed belting, the slip may occur at belt and pulley, smaller and bigger pulley, where we can say that there is a slip at pulley 1 and pulley 2, and that slip is also required to be considered. So considering the slip at the belt, slip of the belt over the pulleys, we can calculate the diameter D2. The maximum total slip is around 2 to 3%. So making use of this slip consideration, we can calculate the diameter D1 and D2, and which can set it as a standard value from the manufacturer's catalog. After getting the diameters known, we can calculate the corrected velocity of the belt, because the diameters which we calculate according to particular velocity is D1 calculated. However, we select standard value of D1, so there is definitely a deviation from what is required and what is accepted, and that's why there must be correction once again in velocity actually the belt is going to be used. So this is actual velocity of the belt which we are going to operate by considering the standard values of diameters of the pulleys. So this is V corrected. Then the load correction factor is obtained from application point of view. As I said, that is a referring certain service conditions, normal load, steady load, etc., according to which we have to get some correction factor for the load. Means we have to increase the load rather than transmit it, power transmit it. So that's why we have to increase the power transmission capacity by a certain factor, and that has been referred from this standard table. For example, if I am using this application for compressors, I will be using the correction factor as 1.3. After that, we have to calculate the angle of contact for smaller pulley, as angle of contact plays an important role in power transmission. Being it is a friction drive between a pulley and belt, we have to consider the angle of contact or angle of wrap of the belt with the pulley, because that affects directly the tensions in the belt, which further affect the power transmission and torque transmission capacity. So we calculate the angle of wrap or angle of contact of smaller pulley with the belt by this equation for open belt and cross belt. However, manufacturers are using standard value of theta as angle of contact, that is normally 180 degrees, and hence why the tested power transmitting capacity of the belt, what they refer in the market as a power rating of belt, is being used at 180 degree angle. However, practically we are using the belt's angle of contact other than 180 degrees. So to compensate this deviation, some angle of contact factor is given by the manufacturer's data, and that is been used as a value calculated theta s by these equations, and corresponding we search the value of FD from the standard table. After getting this correction factor for load and correction factor for angle of contact, we can calculate the design power. Power transmitting capacity is known, which is multiplied by these two factors to get the maximum power required to be transmitted by the belt, called the design power. So we have to design for this power, the particular belt. So this is maximum power. Then we have to calculate the power rating of the belt. The manufacturer is making available the belts in terms of its power rating. The power rating is given by the company or manufacturer. For example, the Dunlop Fort belt is a variety of belt from Dunlop company, for which the power transmitting capacity is given as 0.0147 kilowatt per ply per mm. Width of the belt, it is 0.0147, and it is belt is operated at a velocity of 5.08 meters per second. So this is the data referred by manufacturer. So with the help of this particular data, we have to make use of this belt for actual power rating, and that has been calculated by V corrected, because the V velocity at which this belt is going to actually operate is not for 5.08 meters per second, but it is to a velocity which is operating velocity of this belt. And we know that the power is proportional to velocity, and that's why we are making use of this equation to calculate actual power transmitting capacity of Dunlop Fort belt per ply per mm. So this is equation we can use. Similarly, the equations for other varieties of belts can be used. So this is power rating of the belt per mm per ply we can calculate. Once the power rating of the belt we calculate for standard belt, we can calculate the width required for the belt by the equation design power divided by power rating per mm per ply. So as it is per ply, we multiply it by number of plies here, and that's why this becomes a width in mm required. So width required in mm for the belt under consideration is considered to be a design power divided by power rating of the belt calculated just as earlier point, and number of plies. Normally the number of plies referred in the market are 3 to 6 ply for industrial applications, and corresponding data is made available by the manufacturer. For example, the widths available in the market for 3 ply belt of Dunlop company, something like these widths, etc. 4 ply. So we put on these values of ply 3, 4, 5, 6, we can get possible 4 answers of required width. Some of the plies may not even satisfy the requirement. For example, if this width calculated comes more than 76, so 3 ply belt cannot be used at all. So likewise, we can sort out some options, and whatever remaining options are there out of 4, we select the best possible one. The best possible one can be the answer which is having the width calculated almost nearest to this one or exactly available width, so there is no wastage as such. So this is the way we can calculate all the requirements of the bail drive in terms of width, thickness and diameter of the pulleys. The last point in calculation is the length of the belt. The length of the belt depends upon the system, whether it is open system or cross system. In this case, here we consider the open system of the belt, in which the length of the belt is calculated as the length AB, then RBCD, then length DE and REFA. So this is the length of the belt which we can calculate by simple geometrical relationship, referring the figure here, and that can come something like this equation. So similarly, you can also calculate for cross belting, and that's the way we calculate the length of the belt in mm or in meters. So once this is calculated by all above steps, the design solution will be obtained as, so diameter of smaller pulley is calculated, diameter of larger pulley is calculated, width of belt is known or calculated, number of plies are considered, standard values and length of belt L is calculated. So this is the way we can decide upon all the dimensions which we set an objective of the design of the flat belt at the beginning. So the answers to all these values we get it from all above steps. Now with the following, with the steps described in the video here, I hope that a student can design now the flat belt drive by using manufacturer's data. The input for them I am providing here as an exercise, so one can try for this and get a proper solution. Thank you.